Hey, Pastor Steve Waldron here. I've got my trusty little Haley's Bible Handbook. One of the things about Haley's that I think is highly underrated is not only the great history section in the back, but the archaeological section in the front. He's got one of the most voluminous archaeological proof sections, especially for the book of Genesis, in the front that I have ever seen. So we're going to look at a couple things that he says in here and just see if this is still maybe current. So the antediluvian origin of writing, this would be the pre-flood, the pre-deluge origin of writing. So he talks about this ancient historian Berosius related a tradition that Zixubras, the Babylonian Noah, buried the sacred writings before the flood on tablets of baked clay at Sippar, and afterward dug them up. There was a tradition among Arabs and Jews that Enoch invented writing and left a number of books. An ancient Babylonian king recorded that he loved to read the writings of the age before the flood. Ashurbanipal, founder of Nineveh's great library, referred to inscriptions of the time before the flood. Now, in certain parts of the creation community, like some parts of Answers in Genesis, they would say the world that then was that there's nothing that exists that was pre-flood, that everything was destroyed and we don't have any access to anything. And they might be doing that because they're running into some problems with some different discoveries in that type thing. But there's this that seems to say that there's pre-flood writings. Now, let me just keep going into this. Antediluvian books. Some pre-flood inscriptions have been found. Figure 2 is a pictographic tablet found by Dr. Langdon at Kish under the flood deposit. Figure 3, seals found by Dr. Schmidt at Farah under the flood layer, and Dr. Woolley found pre-flood seals at Ur. Seals were the earliest form of writing representing a person's name, identifying ownership, serving as a signature on letters, contracts, receipts, and various kinds of writing. Each person had his own seal. Seals were carved by delicate saws or drills on small pieces of stone or metal. In use, they were impressed on clay tablets. The clay was yet soft. And pictographic writing. Writing began when God put a mark or a sign on Cain. That mark stood for an idea. Thus, mark, signs, pictures can be used to record ideas. So, fantastic stuff. Now, they've just found, like in some of the ancient caves, there is a unanimity of 30 different markings that have found in the caves all over Europe. So they're like, hey, this must be kind of the origins of writing here. And so they're trying to figure out, what do these 30 things symbolize? What do these 30 things mean? What's trying to be communicated here? And in looking through it, and looking through hieroglyphics and Paleo-Hebrew and Phoenician, it's like, hey, there's a lot of congruity here. So that's just fascinating. So it's just speculative about writing before the flood. Ancient man obviously was extremely brilliant, you know. Adam would have been in the Garden of Eden. He would have been a genius, obviously. And so they already had needles there in the Garden of Eden. And so when they got out of the Garden of Eden, they would have just been geniuses. They were living to be 900 plus years of age, so they would have learned things. And then some of like the Sumerian writings talk about the Anunnaki that came and taught people to do certain things, like women how to paint their faces and men how to make martial arts and warfare and this type of thing, which we would probably say those were demons that came and taught those things. But some of the intricacies of the pottery and stuff, I've read that we sometimes don't even know how they did the things they did. So like some of the colors with the lapis lazuli and all this, how gorgeous, how beautiful it is, and some of the inscriptions and the reliefs and all this kind of stuff. So fascinating Haley's Bible Handbook. I'm probably doing some more things about the archaeology found in here. Great stuff. Talk with you later. He talks about the flood layer too, and that's something that's not talked about a lot, that there is a flood layer deposit all around the world. So God bless. Talk with you later in Jesus' name.